Man, thanks so much for contacting me. I know like it's probably just going crazy for you because I saw you in like Sun and all the other like papers and everything like that, but
Yeah, it's pretty crazy, yeah.
I'm super glad that you have a moment for me. That's totally awesome. So let's get right to it. Who are you?
I'm Dawson Raymond. I was born in Toronto, East York, man. And yeah, I've just been working out here in Calgary, and then I don't know, I decided to do this gig here, you know?
Right on. How old are you?
I'm 28.
Cool. So what have you been doing online?
I'm just posing as a younger aged girl and getting these pedophiles to meet me, and I'm confronting them.
All right, so first question, describe what is it like being a 13-year-old girl on the internet in the year 2015?
Oh, it's not. Oh man, it's disgusting, dude. Like, honestly, like I've told the other guys there, like it didn't take me long to find these guys, right? Like there was a list of them within like, you know, like 20 minutes, man. So I mean, it's bad, right? Like people gotta watch their kids and turn their Wi-Fi off on their shit, man, because this is just, it's out of control.
So, like, how do you catch them?
Well, I actually wait for them to bait me out, right? Like
So, like, they're
I
offering after they know that it's a younger girl, they're offering, hey, where can I pick you up?
Yeah. So I let them do the talking basically. Like I don't say anything until they start talking to me,
Gotcha. Why make the videos?
right? Well, because in my opinion, man, to be honest, like, you know, these guys go, they get convicted. Even the guys that get convicted, right? Like they go to jail for how long, you know? Not very long. And they're in protective custody when they go in there. So I mean, what are they really fucking learning, man? Honestly. You know what I mean? They're not learning nothing. And then they get out and just do the same shit over and over again.
Absolutely. So you think like the public shame part of the whole thing is probably more
Oh,
powerful than a year behind bars?
absolutely. Absolutely. What do you think's happening to these guys now?
Yeah, I
You know,
agree with
like
you, man.
their jobs are gone. You know, if they had wives before, they're gone. If they had fucking a family, it's gone and fucking good because, you know what I mean? Who knows what they're doing to their own kids if they're going to be doing this to, you know, it's disgusting, man.
Yeah.
You know?
So what about like posting the vid like so these vids that you've posted already, that's like before these guys have gone to court and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Do you have any feelings about that? 'Cause I know some people on the internet are saying like, "Oh, like how could you post these guys' videos? They haven't even been convicted yet." Like, what do you say to those
Oh,
people?
you know, because all right, well, you know. Whatever. Like I understand that you can get, you know, lawsuits put on you for these kind of things, but I mean, I don't got any money, man. What are you gonna get from me? You know?
Right.
Like if you wanna sue me, go ahead, buddy. What are you gonna take? My next check for $1,000 that I worked 2 weeks for? Go ahead.
And on top of that, it's only going to make you even more famous, basically. I mean, if a
Well,
pedophile
you know,
sued you, you'd be like on the news again all over the place, so.
well yeah, well you know, if like Well, that's the thing, right? And like the public, I mean, there's some people like that are saying, you know, leave it to the police and whatnot. And I mean, the police do their job too, man. They do, but it's just not enough. You know what I mean? It's not enough. It's clearly not enough. If I was on there for that amount of time and had that many, you know, sick fuckers on my chat logs
Yeah.
and shit. You know what I mean? It's unreal. So.
So what about like the two videos that you've made so far? Do you know, like, have the guys been charged yet, or have you brought that info to
Well,
cops?
I went into the station there, and yeah, like I gave them all my information. I let them take the fake profile I had online, right?
Yeah.
But and that was only with those two guys. So,
Yeah.
you know, each time I'll have to make a new one or whatever, right? Which is too easy to do. And this is another thing I want to bring to attention. You know, how hard is it to stop this when, you know, like this is okay, here's something to bring in the prospect here, really.
Yeah.
All right, look how they shut my Facebook down, all because of all the hype. So they needed me to prove that I was who I was, so they needed ID for me. That's why my Facebook got shut down.
Yeah.
And explain that to everybody. Now, why can't they do the same with these dating sites where you need to have ID to fucking sign up, right? And then these little girls wouldn't be on these sites because they do that, right?
Yeah,
these
little girls do that. And then on top of that, anybody who's using their ID, I mean, to get on the site is going to probably be less likely to do something illegal.
And that's the thing, right? Yeah. It would make things a lot better. I mean, it wouldn't stop it completely, but then there's still me and Justin on there getting rid of these guys, so whatever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's another thing I want everyone to know about Justin Payne, too, man. He's in Toronto.
Random acts of kindness at 7:22 in the morning on Friday.
Yeah, I checked him out, too. Yeah, I was going to ask you if you knew anybody else doing this.
Oh, this is my day, man. That's my freaking brother right there, man, honestly.
Right on.
And you know, we're going to be linking up soon and doing a couple together, so you guys can all watch for that too, man.
Sick. Have you heard of this guy in the UK? There's a guy called Stinson Hunter in the UK.
Yeah, you know, I heard about that. I actually had that UK reporter that's there. He did an article on me too as well.
Right on.
And he said that guy, I don't know, I think something went wrong with him or something, but he was explaining, but I'm not sure exactly what's going on with
Yeah,
that,
no, he had videos a few years ago, and I don't think there's been any updates for a little while, so I don't really know what's happened with him.
He probably did something wrong, right? Like,
I don't really know, but I just remember seeing his videos and kind of seeing it. It seems like, I don't know, maybe the past 5 years, it's sort of become this, like, new idea that people are saying, hey, you know what, I could do that. Or they saw the To Catch a Predator series that was on, you know, a couple of years ago, and it's like, you know, that's, you know, so easy to do with YouTube now, right?
That's inspiring, but that's another thing, is you can't be doing that and putting it on YouTube, right? Like, that's not, if I were to be putting this on YouTube, I'd be in some more trouble than I should be, you know what I mean? So that's not I don't suggest anyone doing that and putting it on YouTube, just so everybody knows.
So what's the difference in your mind then between like the Facebook video or the YouTube
because
video?
Because YouTube, you can make money, right? I mean, I don't know exactly how it works, but I heard you get a certain amount on YouTube and you can start making money. Right?
Gotcha. Yes, that is true.
That's
yeah.
That's not what we're doing here, man.
Yeah, I run a YouTube channel and I can explain that to you. Basically, when you put up a video, if it gets approved for monetization, you can choose whether or not you want ads to go on it. So for instance, with my videos, I usually go, like, if it's a video that's 2 years old or older, then yeah, I'll put ads on it. If people are still watching my stuff that's 2 years old.
I don't know. And personally, like, I did not expect it to get that big that quick. Like, I was talking to Justin, he was like, yeah, man, I've been doing this for like 2 years, and then you do it overnight and you're just famous.
Well,
like, what?
I think there's a few things about it. I would say, number one, there's a visual appeal. The guy that has the face tattoo makes this thing a whole lot more hardcore somehow, you know?
Yeah, I guess so.
I think the other thing is somehow the perfect storm, maybe, with the abduction of the girl in Crow's Nest Pass just recently.
So it's just kind of going together.
Yeah, I think people kind of just, I don't know, I think perfect storm of internet kind of, you know, hashtags worked out in your favor somehow, but
yeah, man. I, you know, and that's another thing too, is I'm not just out to help with just this, man. I'm willing to help anybody that needs help, right? So,
gotcha.
You know, if anyone messages me and needs something or needs anything, like needs something posted for funds or something like that, you let me know and I'll do my best to put it on my page for you.
Gotcha. Should other people do what you're doing?
No. I don't suggest it at all for anyone else whatsoever.
Just hard to sleep at night, see too many sick things, or what?
It's not very good for your mental health, I'll tell you that much. Like, I'm doing good, right? I've always been really, really good, strong-minded. So, I mean, this is something I've been planning for a bit in my own head anyways, right?
Yeah.
I've had enough fucking stories been told to me where it's just I've had enough of it, you know what I mean? So,
yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't suggest it to anyone else, and I mean, it comes with a lot of shit, man. So if anyone does decide to go and do it, just be ready for a fucking storm of shit upon you.
Yeah, I understand that. Yeah. Are you ever afraid that you're gonna show up to meet one of these guys and it's gonna be like somebody way scarier than you thought, or like he has a gun or something like that?
No, I've never really been afraid of that kind of shit, man. If I was, I wouldn't be doing this, right? I mean, That's the thing. I'm willing to put myself in harm's way for these kids, man. I don't give. I don't. You know, that's not my style, bro. I've always been. You know. Let's put it this way. I'm like Hercules back in the day, man. All right.
All right. Cool.
All right.
Is there anything else I should ask you, or something that I haven't said?
No, man. You basically covered most of it. Yeah, man. I mean, all right.
A lot of my fans told me to tell you that they think you're a hero. I mean, I got like, I don't know, probably over 100 comments on the thing I posted. I said I was going to talk to you, and I said, you know, what would you ask this guy? And I didn't get a whole lot of actual question feedback, but the one that was pretty common there was, what kind of costume does this superhero wear? Because everybody is honestly, I mean, I'm not being facetious, they're honestly calling you a hero, and they think that, like, that you deserve that kind of status, you know. So.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. My best costume I could wear is jeans and a wife beater, man, because I'm tatted up from head to toe, and that's pretty intimidating to some, right?
Yeah. So the intimidation factor is important to you. Just like when you're meet, if you're going to meet somebody, just showing who you are as a person helps to.
That's the big thing too, right? Because I'm like, you know, I'm not scared of much, man. I've never really have been. I mean. I've been through stuff where, and that's the other thing, I don't have any prior charges really, right? Like, I have, like, a misdemeanor for a broken window my buddy broke years ago or something stupid, I can't even remember.
But, yeah. That's good to let us know, because I think some people might look at a guy with a tattoo on his face and go, oh, he must have spent time in prison or whatever,
that,
right?
You know what, no, that, and I'll explain that too, that was for, that's because I've lost two people close to me, man, and that's why the cross is beside it as well, right?
Yep.
So if you could explain that to people and let people know that, because I have been getting a lot of slander on that, too, like, oh, he's, you know, whatever. But, you know, I just want to say thanks for the love to everybody, and haters are going to hate, man. You know, there's not much you can do about that. But, I mean, I try to put a positive spin on everything. So for the ones that are going to send me negativity, I got nothing but positivity for you.
Yeah, that's the way to do it, man. Like, having run a Facebook page myself with a couple thousand fans for the last while, the thing that you tend to find out is that you just got to stay positive. No matter what you say, if you're popular and people are listening to you, there's going to be somebody out there with a crummy opinion just to say the opposite thing that everybody else is saying. So you just got to ignore the negative and kill it with positivity for sure.
Absolutely. And like you just said, man, there's always negativity with positive. When there's a positive, there's a negative. Right? Yeah. I mean, they go together, man.
Yeah.
So.
Cool, man. Well, thanks so much for your time tonight. I look forward to seeing more stuff that you do, and I know all my fans are probably going to be watching for that next video.
Oh, yeah, man. It'll be up soon, right? It's just been pretty crazy. I've been dealing with a lot of stuff last couple of days, so it kind of took me off the radar there for what I was doing. But I'm going to finish off this work week and make some more money because I'm kind of broke right now.
Yeah.
So I still got my normal job, man. You know, I can't quit my day job still. But, yeah, man, that next video will be up soon. And like I said, look out for me and Justin together, man, because that shit's going to happen to you real soon.
Yeah, last thing I'll ask there. One of my fans actually had put it up just while we were talking. One of the comments came through, and they asked if there was any way that they could help. And I think they might mean in terms of, like, you know, donating to your cause or something like that. So, I mean...
my cause, I will have a GoFundMe account going up. I don't have it up yet, but that's going to be for my mother's cause. So if you guys want to donate to me, it can be for my mother.
Okay.
And that's the only thing I'll accept money for. I'm not going to accept money for doing this for
Is your mom sick right now or something?
Yeah, she's real bad. I got a video up on my page. You can check it out.
Okay. Well, I wish your mom the best health. I know what it's like to have a parent go through some difficult health stuff. So
yeah, absolutely, man.
I wish you the best, man.
All right, dude. I thank you for the interview, and thank you for giving me that positive feedback, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, man. I'm going to stay in touch with you.